Jay Gatsby. I grew up on a small farm in North Dakota. Even when I was young, I was obsessed with success. I had to be the best. I wanted to make it. I wanted to be somebody important. And I couldn't do that on a farm. I ran away when I was 17. I had to get away. I didn't have a plan, so I just did what I knew how to do. I fished. I lived off of clams and salmon. I wasn't satisfied with this new life. I had left the farm to become something great. I went to St. Olaf's University for a few weeks, paying my way on a janitor's salary. It didn't take too long before I realized that this is not what I had had in mind. I didn't want to be a janitor. I wanted to be a millionaire. So I quit. No matter what I was doing, I had to get off of that farm. At least out there fishing, I was free. Then one day, I met a man who would change my life forever. Dan Cody. He was everything I wanted to be. Successful, wealthy. I spent years with him. Then one day, he died suddenly. He was meant to leave a lot of his fortune to me, but for some reason I never saw that money. Poor and lost again, I decided to enlist in the army.
Gatsby!
Yes, Drill Sergeant!
Can you not follow orders, Gatsby?
Drill Sergeant was terrible.
Well, then get down and do it right this time!
Basic training was grueling.
All the way down, Gatsby! No.
They worked us to the bone and we never caught a break.
You get it right. You're wearing out my patience. Come on, man! Show some guts here! Come on! Move! Move! Move!
But we needed it.
Run, Gatsby! Run! Come on!
War is brutal. One day I left Camp Taylor for a bit to explore Louisville, Kentucky. Some of the guys from Camp Taylor told me about a girl named Daisy who was a lot of fun.
Evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Some men from Camp Taylor told me that there were some beautiful houses to see in Louisville. I think your house is a prime example.
Why don't you come up here so I can hear you a little bit better?
Okay.
Plenty of guys had already been with Daisy, but it was different for us. I wasn't like the other guys for her. And she wasn't just another girl.
Hey, my father owns a lot of great restaurants in Louisville. Have you ever been to one?
Talking to Daisy was like talking to a goddess. She had everything. She was rich. She was beautiful. She was perfect. I held on to every word that she said as if it were the air that I breathed.
You're gonna make planes now that can fly people like a bird? That's why Susie cries so much. Anyway, Jake, tell me about you. I want to know every detail.
What do you want to know?
Everything. Where are you from? What do you do? What are your parents like?
I was born in San Francisco. My grandfather was an associate of J.P. Morgan. My dad owned some steel companies, had a lot of stocks and things like the railroad.
That's terrific.
Father died of the flu, and mom died shortly afterwards. They called it a heart attack. But anyways, they put my father's businesses into a trust for me and gave it to my uncle. And I've got people running things for me out in California.
Oh.
They send me a check every once in a while.
Oh. I lied to her, and then I had to leave.
I'm sorry. The army owns me. For now, at least.
I wish you didn't have to go.
I don't leave until tomorrow. Daisy, wait for me.
Okay, I'd wait two lifetimes for you.
Then I was off to war. War was like nothing else. Constant fear of death. Perpetual danger. always scared, always on alert. Mostly it was just patrolling the perimeter. Every now and then something exciting would happen. Then one day I got a letter from home. From Daisy.
My love, things have been so boring since you left. I miss you terribly. I think of you every second. Everybody is pulling for you to beat those Germans. I can't wait until you return. With love, Daisy.
Hearing from her, thinking about her, made everything easier. Whenever I got scared or stressed out, I just focused on Daisy. She was my motivation. When things got really bad and I thought I wouldn't make it out, I just remembered what I was fighting for. After my service was over, I was offered an education at Oxford. I had already told Daisy that I was rich and well off. I decided that this would be the perfect opportunity to become the man that I told Daisy I was. But when I didn't come home like everybody else, Daisy started to worry. I got another letter.
My love, I wish I could hear from you. I miss you more every day. Thinking of you. Love, Daisy.
I couldn't tell her what I was doing. It would ruin my image. So I kept studying day after day until another letter came.
Dear Jay, I don't understand why you're not back yet. I hope all is well with you. It has been nearly a year since you and I saw each other last. I'm marrying Tom Buchanan next month. I'm sorry, Jay. Sincerely, Daisy.
Naturally, I panicked and went back home. I had to stop that marriage. I love Daisy.
Yes, Daisy. Scientifically speaking, women are dangerous drivers. Their minds are set for child-rearing, and they can't comprehend how to drive an automobile mechanically or psychologically.
I was too late. Daisy, my love, had married Tom Buchanan. I quickly got to work on a new plan. I couldn't let Daisy go, even if she was married to another man. I went into business with a man named Meyer Wolfsheim. He was a shrewd gambler, but he was smart. He taught me a lot, and we got a lot done. Money came fast, and I decided to buy myself a big house. All in hopes that Daisy would come back to me. Now I throw parties every weekend. All sorts of people come to them. It's a great time for a lot of people. I really just throw them in hopes that Daisy will come to one. She married Tom, but I still love her. She has my whole heart. I would die for her. What's life without love? And what is love without a fight?
Oh, how wrong can you be? Oh, to fall in love was my very first mistake. Was I to know I was far too much in love to see? Oh, jealousy, look at me now. Jealousy, got me somehow. You gave me.